Good morning, students. I hope you all are well. Today we are going to continue with our topic, coordination in plants. Earlier we have read that plants do not have specific organs or any specific system for control of their body, but still they show different types of movement for their growth or independent of growth. And we have read about tropic movements and nestic movements. Means the movements which are growth dependent, they are tropic movements, and which are growth independent, they are nestic movements. Today we are going to continue with this topic. But before that, we are going to discuss how these tropic movements occur in plant body. Remember I told you that in phototropism, plants, specifically the shoot part, shows movement towards the light. And in geotropism, plants show movement towards the gravity or away from the gravity. But how these movements occur in plants? The answer is your plant hormones. And the hormone which is specifically responsible for all these movements is number one, auxin. The number one plant hormone, that is auxin, A-U-X-I-N. Auxin is responsible for all these kind of movements. How? Let's first discuss about phototropism. As I told you, if there is a plant which is near a window from where light is coming, that plant shows a bend towards the light. But how it occurs? This is just because as this auxin, this is a hormone, it is sensitive to any kind of change in the plant body. So as soon as light enters into the dark room or it reaches to the plant body, it shifts towards the opposite direction of the light. That means if the light is coming from the right, auxin will shift to the left. And this auxin is responsible for the plant growth. So kya hoga, jo aapka left side wala part hai, wo zyada lamba ho jayega aur right wala part छोटा रह जाएगा. सो स्लोली एंड स्टेडिली ये बड़ा होता जाएगा और ये लेफ्ट वाला पार्ट आपका बड़ा होता जाएगा, राइट वाला छोटा. सो इट विल अपीयर लाइक इट इज़ बेंडिंग टूवर्ड्स द लाइट. सो दिस इज जस्ट ऑक्सिन विच इज़ रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द मूवमेंट ऑफ द प्लांट टूवर्ड्स एनी काइंड ऑफ चेंज और एनी स्टिमुलाई. सिमिलरली इन द केस ऑफ हाइड्रोट्रॉपिज्म, इफ देयर इज वाटर सोर्स and plant is there or roots are there, these plants or their roots will be sensitive towards the water. That means again ek ye kya stimulus hai jiske liye aapka auxin kya hoga, sensitive, and it will shift towards the opposite direction. Aur aapka opposite direction mein kya hoga, auxin zyada, wo opposite direction mein aapka growth zyada ho jayegi aur dusri direction mein kam. So it will appear like bending towards the source of water. Similarly like here in phototropism. So this is auxin which is responsible for the plant growth or which is responsible for the growth of plant towards the stimulus. Okay, so auxin is very important plant hormone which is responsible for the growth of plant, and it also helps the plants to grow longer. सो आपके प्लांट्स की जो हाइट बढ़ती है, दैट इज़ अगेन विद द हेल्प ऑफ ऑक्सिन. तो आपका प्लांट लंबा लंबा होता जाता है, वो ऑक्सिन की वजह से होता है. ओके, नाउ नेक्स्ट प्लांट हार्मोन, दैट इज साइटोकाइनिन. ऑल ऑफ दीज प्लांट हार्मोन्स आर मेंशन ऑन द सेम पेज. आपका ये पेज नंबर 122 पर ही ये सारे हार्मोन्स दिए हुए हैं. सो सेकेंड हार्मोन इज साइटोकाइनिन. एज साइटो मीन्स सेल, दिस साइटो मीन्स सेल. सो एज द नेम इंडिकेट, साइटोकाइनिन क्या करेगा, इट इज़ मेनली रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द सेल डिविजन, सेल एनलार्जमेंट, सेल ग्रोथ. तो आपकी सेल टू सेल ग्रोथ या सेल की लंबाई के लिए, सेल की डिविजन के लिए आपका क्या रिस्पॉन्सिबल है, साइटोकाइनिन. एंड इट ऑल्सो प्रमोट्स शूट ग्रोथ. तो आपके शूट रीजन की जो ग्रोथ है वो भी आपका साइटोकाइनिन एनहांस करता है या प्रमोट करता है. Okay, now the third plant hormone is gibberellin. third plant hormone is gibberellin. Gibberellin. It again promotes flowering and growth of the stem. तो आपके stem region की growth के लिए फिर से क्या responsible है? Gibberellin. And it also promotes flowering in plants. So आपके ये जितने भी hormones हैं, auxin, gibberellin, cytokinin, all of these are also considered as positive hormones. That means they are helpful in the growth of the plant. Positive growth. यानी आपकी growth आपके plant को बढ़ाने में काम करते हैं तीनों ही hormones. Okay, auxin, which promotes root growth, also helps the plant to grow longer. Cytokinin, which promotes shoot growth and cell division, cell enlargement, cell growth, and gibberellin, which promotes flowering in plants as well as which helps in growth of stem region. Now, the next hormone which we are going to discuss now is abscisic acid. Fourth hormone is abscisic acid. Abscisic acid. This abscisic acid is a hormone which retards growth. यानी आपका जो ये abscisic acid है इसे हम क्या नाम देंगे? Negative hormone. यानी ये plant growth बढ़ाने की बजाय क्या करता है? Negative effects होते हैं इसके plant growth पर. ये plant growth को रोकता है. You must have seen during autumn season, आपका जब पतझड़ आता है तो आपके पत्ते अपने आप झड़ने लगते हैं. Why? They fall down from the plants or the trees themselves just because of abscisic acid. तो plant growth को रोकना, आपके फूल, आपके फल अपने आप पेड़ों से झड़ जाते हैं, पौधों से झड़ जाते हैं. Why? Because of this abscisic acid. तो plant growth को रोकने का काम कौन करता है? Abscisic acid. Sensins. We call it sensins. तो आपकी पत्तियों को अपने आप झड़ने को हम क्या कहते हैं? Sensins. So sensins of leaves is done just because of abscisic acid. Now there is one more hormone, but this is not mentioned in your book, which is ethylene. That is ethylene. This ethylene is again negative hormone, which helps in fruit ripening. यानी आपके आप देखते हो fruits घर पर लेकर आया है 2-3 days में और within a day sometimes आपके fruits अपने आप पककर खराब होने लगते हैं, गलने लगते हैं. They just because of the hormone ethylene. So आपके fruits की ripening, अपने आप आपके फल जो पेड़ों पर लगे वो पककर अपने आप झड़ने लगते हैं, अपने आप टूट कर गिर जाते हैं. Again they are because of ethylene. So आपके abscisic acid और ethylene, ये दोनों ही hormones कैसे हैं? Negative hormones. That means they are responsible for retarding the plant growth. But आपने जो पहले तीन पढ़े थे, auxin, cytokinin, gibberellin, these three are considered as positive hormones. They help in promoting plant growth. Okay, I hope this topic is clear to you. Now your homework is to do these 5 blue box questions in your notebook. First question is, what are plant hormones? We have just discussed. How is the movement of leaves of the sensitive plant different from the movement of a shoot towards leaf light? This also we have discussed now, just because of the auxin. Third question is, give an example of a plant hormone that promotes growth. अभी आपने पढ़ा तो आपके auxin, cytokinin, gibberellin, you can write any one of these. Fourth is, how do auxins promote the growth of a tendril around a support? Again, we have discussed now, auxin, कैसे आपका plant growth करता है? Phototropism के लिए, hydrotropism, similarly, support के लिए. तो P tendril का example जो हमने पहले discuss किया था, so answer is your auxin. So you have to write all these answers in your notebook. And the last is, design an experiment to demonstrate hydrotropism. So this you have to yourself. If you do not find the answer, then I'll tell you in the next video. Okay, take care and write these answers in your notebook. Thank you.